Coordinate plane distances. Please fill in these notes as you go through this worksheet and make sure you're paying attention to the two things that I've highlighted. So on the coordinate grid, if two points lie in the same quadrant, you're going to subtract the absolute values of the appropriate coordinates. But if two points lie in different quadrants, then you would add the absolute values of the appropriate coordinates. So I have these points highlighted here in yellow and these in blue. So let's continue. So the first part of the worksheet asks you to find the distance between the pair of points at -3, 1 and -2, 1. So when I look at -3, 1, which is here, and I look at -2, 1, which is here, I see that they're in different quadrants. So I'm going to be adding my absolute value. So since it's different, you will add. So because -3, 1 and 2, 1 are in different quadrants, I'm going to add the absolute values. So I notice that they are across from each other horizontally, and the horizontal is my x value. So if I look at my ordered pair, I have -3, 1 and I have 2, 1. So I'm looking at the distance of -3, 1 to the y-axis and the distance of 2, 1 to the y-axis. So I'm measuring the distance. So the distance is the absolute value of -3, which of course is 3. And then the absolute value of 2 is 2. Remember, absolute value is the distance from 0, and distance is always positive. And so then I would just add those two numbers, 3 and 2 are 5. So the distance from -3, 1 to +2, 1 is 5. All right. And then I look at the next ordered pair, and it says -3, 3 and -3, 1. So when I plot these points and I look at them, I see that -3, 3 is here. Whoops, I want that to be yellow. And -3, 1 is here. And those two points are in the same quadrant. And so since they're in the same quadrant, I am going to subtract the absolute values. So here I'm looking at the vertical distance. Vertical are my y values. So I'm going to take my y values and write those in absolute value. So in the first ordered pair, the y value is 3. So the absolute value of 3 is 3. And the absolute value of 1 is 1. And so 3 minus 1 equals 2. So the distance between these two points are 2. So please pause the video and do the next two questions on your own and check. So I looked at my point for number 3 and I saw that it was 2, 1. And then the second point for number 3 was 2, -4. I know that these are in different quadrants because I noticed that the first number 2 is the same in both ordered pairs. So the things that are different are the 1 and the -4. And I know that the 1 and the -4 are going to be in different quadrants because they have different signs. So that's how I knew I needed to add them, because when you are in different quadrants, you add. The second question, I look at my ordered pairs. I have 2, -4, and I have 4, -4. I see that the -4s are the same in both problems. So I have -4 and -4. So the things that I'm looking at are the 2 and the 4. Because they have the same sign, they're going to be in the same quadrant. And when you're in the same quadrant, you subtract. And so I've got my work here. So make sure you did that correctly. On the next slide, you're being asked to plot some points. So you're going to plot these points on your coordinate grid and find the distance between them. Before you do that, I would like you please to label them. So we're going to call this one point A and this B. We'll call this point point C and point D, and this point point E and point F, so that we can talk about them when we're doing it. So go ahead and plot those points, and then you can restart the video once you're done. You are going to be finding the distance between these two points by using the absolute value formula. You might think, oh, but I can just look at it and I know how far apart they are. You need to use the absolute value formula because just like anything in math, you start off with easy stuff and then it gets more difficult. And so if you learn how to do it with the easy stuff, when you get to the difficult stuff, you know exactly what to do. All right, so pause the video, plot your points, Find the distance between your points by using the absolute value formula, and then restart the video to check yourself. Thank you. All right, so the first part of this next question, question five, you should have noticed that A and B were in different quadrants, and different quadrants means we're going to be adding. So when I look at my ordered pair, I see that they have the same X, but different Ys. So I'm going to look at the absolute value of those Y coordinates. The absolute value of 5 is 5. The absolute value of negative 5 is 5. And then I add those two numbers, 5 plus 5 is 10 units. So point A and point B are 10 units apart from one another. Here I have points C and point D. I notice once again that they are in different quadrants. The first coordinate, the X's, are the same. So I'm looking just at the Y's. So the absolute value of 1 is 1. The absolute value of negative 3 is 3. Because they're in different quadrants, I'm going to add 1 plus 3 equals 4 units. And then the final question, also vertically, they are apart from one another. I look at them and I notice that they are in the same quadrant. So I'm going to have the same quadrant. So I found the absolute value. When I look at these, I'm looking at the negative 5. The absolute value of negative 5 is 5. The absolute value of negative 1 is 1. Because they are in the same quadrant, I'm going to subtract them. So 5 minus 1 is 4. These two points are 4 units apart. All right, so now we're going to go on to the next part of the worksheet, and you are going to plot and label these points on your graph and then find the distance between them. So go ahead and pause the video, do these questions, and then restart the video to check yourself. Thank you. Before you do, though, make sure that you've labeled these points with letters so that you know what they are. So we left off on F on the last one, so let's call this point G. This point H, and this point I, and this point J. That way we can talk about them that way. And you notice that when you write the points on a coordinate grid, the points are always in capital letters. So now I'll pause the video. Thank you. All right. So point G is in quadrant 2, and point H is in quadrant 1, and they're in different quadrants. So I am going to be adding their absolute values. So the absolute value of negative 7 is 7. The absolute value of 5 is 5. And because they were in different quadrants, I add them. So 7 plus 5, that is 12. Okay, next question. I have points I and J. And points I and J lie in the same quadrant. So the absolute value of negative 6 is 6. The absolute value of negative 10 is 10. And because they are in the same quadrant, I'm going to subtract them. So I did 10 minus 6 and I got 4. Had I done 6 minus 10, I would have gotten negative 4. And because distance is always positive, it would be 4 units. So it does not matter the order in which you subtract your absolute values, but you just need to remember that once you get your answer, because you're doing distance, it is also going to be a positive number. So you could do either order. All right, so the next part of the worksheet that you're going to go through is this section. And what I'd like for you to do, please, here is I need you to divide up this part of the worksheet like this. And in this first part, we're going to write what quadrant the points are in. And then we're going to write what the absolute values are. And then we're going to write either the sum or the difference, which is the distance. So what I mean by that is this. Looking at the first one, if I look at positive 7, negative 2, and positive 11, negative 2, 7, negative 2, that's in quadrant 4, and 11, negative 2, that's also in quadrant 4. So since they're in the same quadrant, I'm going to subtract. So I'm going to do the absolute value of 11, which is 11. And the absolute value of 7, which is 7, and 7 minus 4, 11 minus 7 is 4. So the distance there is 4 units. All right, so do those for those and then check and see that you did them correctly. Thank you. All right, so here are the answers to that next section. Number 2 is in quadrant 1 and 4, different quadrant, so I'm going to add. Absolute value of negative is 8. Absolute value of 4 is 4, 8 and 4 are 12. Next points are both in quadrant 4. They're in the same quadrant, so I'll be subtracting. Absolute value of 8 is 8, Absolute value of 5 is 5. 8 less 5 is 3. Next one, first point is in quadrant 3. Second point is in quadrant 2. So I'm going to take the absolute value of 6, which is 6, the absolute value of 5, which is 5, add those because they're in different quadrants and get 11. And then the last answer is here, 2 and 4 are 6. So the next part of the worksheet is interesting. The next part of the worksheet, you're going to have to look at this, and you're going to be finding the coordinates of two different points that are the given distance from these points, both horizontally and vertically. So what does that mean? If we look at question 6, it says you want to be plotting a point that is 5 units away from negative 1, negative 2. And so you notice down here at the bottom, I have a number line. So when I look at my ordered pair, I see that the x value is missing. So the initial x value was negative 1. So I'm going to put a dot on my number line at negative 1. All right, so here's my dot on negative 1. And I'm being asked to find 5 units away from negative 1. So if I go 5 units to the left of negative 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that puts me at negative 6. So the point negative 6, 2 is 5 units away from negative 1, 2. So that would be, as I said, right over here. Okay. But now I need to go in the opposite direction. So if I'm going in the opposite direction from negative 1, and I'm going 5 units away from there, I'm going to count, and I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that puts me at positive 4. So the point 4, 2 is also 5 units away from negative 1, negative 2. And so I'm going to put that point right here. So if I was being asked to find the distance between my new points, I would say from here to here is 5, and from here to here is 5. So the total distance between those two points is 10, because it's 5 units going to the left and 5 units going to the right. That's our lesson for later. But anyway, that's what you're going to be finding out. So what I'd like for you to do, please, is for number 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11, pause the video, find out what the missing coordinate would be. So on this second question, you're looking for the y's. So you're going to be going 8 units from the 4, both to the left and to the right. And then you're going to do the same thing on the y's, the x's, and the x's. So pause the video and fill in these answers. All right. So check your answers, please. And let's go to the very end of the video. So here, you're going to be doing the same thing, and you're going to be finding the distance between these different things. So pause the video and work out what those are. Okay. So for the Ferris wheel, you should have gotten 4 units because they were in the same quadrant. You were going to subtract them. And for the water slide, you should have gotten 7 units because they were in different quadrants. You are going to add them. And go ahead and answer these two questions and then pause the video. So the difference between, or the answers to both of these were D. So thank you for working through this, and go ahead and try the next set of activities to prove that you've learned what we were talking about today. Thank you so much.